Guys, yes, so now I have been back to China, 我回到中国了, and then I still feel very excited about what we have met on last week. So I'm so happy to see you guys again, even though it is online. Okay, so for this lesson, before our lesson, we are going to review what we have learned for last week. All right. So students, I know that you are still at your hometown, and then but we can like do some exercises first. All right. So if you have any question or if you want to like response to my questions, you can like type on the chatting, on the chatting room. Okay, so we can like talk in the chatting room. Okay, yeah. Let's see here. For this one is like what we'll do for the revision. So first of all, look at the pictures here and decide the given words, whether it is right or wrong. All right. So for example, like this one, if it is like in this picture, it is like the plane, the airplane, and then it writes like 飞机. So this one is correct. All right, this is correct. This is an example. Okay, let's see number 13. So from this picture, what can you see from this picture?
茶，
Are you sure this one is cha?
不是咖啡，
Yeah,
咖啡，
it's
咖
a cha.
啡。
Okay, so then we will write a cross here. It is wrong. All right, so this is not cha. Cha is tea, right? So from the picture, what do you think it is? What is it?
咖啡。
Cafe, yeah, very good. Cafe. So that we say this one is called cafe. Yeah, cafe. Okay, very good. So this is cafe. All right. And in pictures number 14, the second picture. So we can see that a group of people, what are they doing? What are they doing?
吃
They
饭。
are 吃饭, yes, very good. So this one we call 吃饭, that should be correct, right? This one is correct, 吃饭. Okay, right, good. This is correct. All right, and then this one. Number 15, pictures number 15. It is said that this one is 米饭. Do you think it's right or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong. Okay, so from the picture, what do you think it is?
Hi.
Cai. Okay, very good. Cai. This is our dishes. Cai. Very good. So that is what we call cai. That's our dishes. All right, cai. Okay, so we need to like do some expand our vocabulary. So if for the rice we call mi fan. So do you know how to say noodles in Chinese? Yes, we have rice, we call mi fan. If we want to say noodles, I know that some of you might like eating noodles, right? And the noodle we'll call mian. Mian. All right, mian. This is noodle. Or sometimes we'll have rice noodles, right? So the noodles is like make of the wheat, but rice noodles sometimes they will make of rice. So some if you want to say rice noodle, I think this is similar in your language, right? So in your language we will have a phone, right? I've seen that in Cambodia, in some restaurant, they will show that, oh, this one is phong. So I think it's similar. Yeah, it's similar in Chinese. All right. So this is will be called fen. Yes. So maybe you can like read after me. Fen. Yeah. Fen.
Fun.
Fen. Yeah, fun. That is rice noodle. It's similar pronounced like fong, right? Fong, fun. And also, I know that you also have white deer, right? In your country, you also have like the great white deer. Is it similar like the noodles, the fried noodles, right?
Yes, love.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Very good. So we also call this white deer in Canton. Yeah, in my hometown. Yeah, we also have white deer. That is the rice, the fried rice. Sorry, the fried noodles. We also call that guai diu, and then we also call this feng. Yeah, it's pronounced similar. I think this is like the similar kind of things, the in the Southeast Asia. All right, so you
Yeah.
can like, yeah, you can like learn it in this way. All right, yeah, very good. Okay, let's see. Picture number 16. So it is said that 这是四个学生, true or false?
四个学生。
Yeah, 四个学生, true or false?
Four
Yes.
Yes, true. Yeah, this is true. You can say true. 四个学生, so you can see that they are studying, right? They are studying. 四个学生, four students. Okay, so if I want to say four friends, do you still remember how to say friends?
朋友。
Hello. Yes, very good. 朋友. Okay, so we will say 四个朋友. Okay, 朋友. You can say 四个朋友. Yeah, and then also like we can call each other friends. We are friends. 我们是朋友. Yes, 我们是朋友. And then 你们是学生. You are a student. 你们是学生. Okay, last one. Last one we see here. So in the last picture, it said that 喝茶. You think they are 喝茶? 他们在喝茶吗? True or false?
喝茶错了是
错. Okay, this is wrong. This is 错, wrong. So what are they doing?
喝可乐。
喝可乐, yeah, very good. 喝可乐. Yes, you can say 他们在喝可乐. Right? 喝可乐. Or maybe you can say that they are like drinking not the 可乐, but they are drinking beer. How do you say beer? Do you still remember?
啤酒。
Yeah, very good. 啤酒. Yes, 啤酒. So we see here, we can drink a lot of things. We can drink 可乐, 喝可乐, 喝茶, 喝啤酒. And sometimes we can, like in the morning, right? In the morning, 我们会喝 milk. How do you say milk?
Neil Nye.
Yeah, very good. 牛奶. Yes, you have learned a lot of like the saying about the drink. Yeah, 牛奶. So you can learn, you can say that. Yeah. So at night we'll喝 牛奶, or in the morning we'll喝 牛奶, right? So in the morning we will also 喝咖啡, right? 我们会喝咖啤酒. Okay, very good. Yes, very good. So you have remembered this quite well. Let's continue. We also do one more exercises here. So in this exercises, we can see that from the left side, it is the question. Okay, it is from somebody say to you or ask you. And then from the right side, it is the answer. Okay, so try to match the questions and then match the answer with the questions. All right, for example, like this one. If people ask you, 你喝水吗? Yeah, 你喝水吗? Would you like some water? And then you can answer, 好的,谢谢. Okay, 好的,谢谢. So you say, okay, thank you, 好的. 好的 means okay, right? All right, let's see. Exercise is number 18. If I ask, 请问这个杯子多少钱? How would you answer? 请问这个杯子多少钱?
Me 25.
Yes, very good. 25. So we could choose letter C, right? So it is asking about the price, right? 多少钱? I think you guys should like remember this saying, this question, 多少钱? Yeah. No, maybe you don't have to know the item or the objects. You can even ask like this one, 多少钱? So you can take out the products and then ask 多少钱? How much? That means how much. Okay? 多少钱? So every time when we ask 多少钱, how much money? You can like tell me, oh, this is like 25 bucks or 25 yuan. Okay, 25. All right, let's see. Question 19. 你想喝什么?
我喝茶, 谢谢.
Yes, very good. 我喝茶, 谢谢. Yes, 我喝茶, 谢谢. That should be letter A. 我喝茶谢谢. Thank you. Yeah, 谢谢. Okay, and then question 20. 你好,这个菜多少钱? Still, same, 多少钱?
这个菜18块.
Yes, 这个菜18块. That should be letter B. 这个菜18块. Alright, very good. Okay. Let's see, number 21. 下午你想去哪儿?
我想去商店买个鼻子。
买个杯子, yes, very good. 我想去商店买个杯子. Okay, that is, this is what we have learned on last week, right? So, 想, that means you want to do something. 我想, okay, 我想. And then if like people ask you, 你想去哪里? And then you can tell people that 我想去商店, yeah, to the shop. And then 买个杯子, buy a cup. All right. So here, let's do more revision. This one is called 下午. 下午 means afternoon, right? Then let's review. How to say morning? How can you say morning?
早上.
Yes, very good. 早上. Yes, you can say 早上 or you can say 上午. Right? And then how to 上午? Yes, 上午. You can say 早上 or 上午. Then how to say afternoon? Oh, sorry, noon.
中午.
Yes, very good. 中午.
Yes, 谢谢了.
Yes, 中午. So for now, we can say now, we can say 下午, right? 下午. And if like, if you like, want to like read with me, we should say 老师下午好.
老师下午好.
Yes, 下午好. Good afternoon, 下午好. Okay? Yeah, very good. 下午好. All right, let's continue. Number 22 says, question. 明天你去学校吗?
明天我去朋友家。
Yes, very good. 不去,明天我去朋友家。 So if I ask you, 明天你们去CGTI吗?
不去,我在家学习。
Okay, you can say 我在家, very good. You are at home. Yeah, very good. 不去,我在家。 So, when is your holiday end? When is your holiday end? When is your holiday? So you still have like two more days or three more days?
One day.
One week. One more week.
This is the last week.
对，是一个星期。
So you still have one more week. Okay, then if I ask you, 下周你们去 CGTI 吗? 下周?
去我CGTI学习。
下周你们去 CGTI学习? So do you know 下周 what this means? That means next week. Next week.
对对。
Yes? Okay, so 下周, if I ask you, 下周你们去 CGTI吗? How would you answer me?
Yeah.
You can say, 是的.
好的，老师。
Yes, 好的 means okay. Alright, so pay attention to this, like a little bit different. If we say 好的, that means okay. If you like to want to say 是的, that means yes. Right? So if I ask you, 下周你们去 CGTI吗? You should answer me like 是的. 是的，我去下周我去 CGTI学习. Very good. 是的, okay, very good.
谢谢啊。
The Chinese is like improving. I'm so happy to see that. Okay, yeah, let's continue. Let's see what we should learn for today. Today, we're going to talk about 你儿子在哪工作? We're going to talk about the job. Okay, 你儿子在哪工作? So first, we should learn some words. Do you still remember what is 儿子?
To his son.
Very good. 儿子 is son. So how do you say daughter?
女儿.
Yeah, very good. 女儿. We say 女儿. Yeah, 女儿. 女儿 means daughter. Okay. So they used to ask guy, 你儿子在哪工作? So 工作 means you work. Alright? Work. And 在哪 means where. So this is the grammar point we need to learn for this week, for today's lesson. Okay, so let's see. First, we should know some vocabulary at the beginning. All right, so let's see about these pictures, try to match it. So number one, we call 爸爸. Which picture is 爸爸?
F. Number I.
Yes, very good. 爸爸. Yeah, number F is 爸爸. And 爸爸和儿子. So this is 儿子. So this is 儿子. This is 爸爸. Okay? And then number two, 医生. Which one is 医生?
E.
Number E.
E, number yes, very good. E. Yeah, number E. 医生. 医生, doctor. Doctor. All right? Number three. 医院.
D.
D, yes, very good. Letter D. This is the hospital. We call 医院. Yeah, 医院. And then number four, we call 椅子.
C.
Number C.
Yeah, number C. Okay. And then also we have 猫.
A.
Number A.
Yes, number A. This is cat. Then 狗.
B.
B, yes, 狗. So we have 猫 and 狗. Do you guys 有, 你们有猫吗?
我没有猫.
Okay. And then how about 狗? 你们有狗吗?
我有一只狗.
八个. That's very good.
谢谢啊.
我有一只狗. Okay, very good. I really want to have a pet dog. 我也想要一只狗. Yeah. So if like ask me to make a wish, I would say 我想要一只狗. want to have a dog.
我想要一只,
yes. So we can also use the word 想. Yeah. 我想要一只狗. Yeah, that means I want to have a dog. 一只狗. Yeah. 我想要一只狗. I want to have a dog. And also, I like dog. 我喜欢狗. I like dog. 我喜欢狗. Okay, so this is the warm-up part, all right? So let's continue. And then for the new word for this lesson, first of all, we should learn two adjective words first. Number one, this is we call 小.
小.
Yes, 小. 小. Do you know what is 小 mean?
Small.
Yes, yeah, small. We call this one is like small. Small. We call 小. Also, like for example, if you like to, if you see some very cute things, for example, like the cute dog, the little dog, we can say 小狗.
小狗.
Yes, yeah, 小狗. And then if you see the cat, it's very little, very cute. You can also say 小猫.
小猫.
小猫. Yes. And then let's see. We have some other words, like for example, this one we call 小学生. Okay, 小学生, 小, small. 小学生 means student, right? So 小学生 means like the primary school student. Okay, primary school student. Yeah, we call 小学生. All right. And then besides 小学生, we also have 小商店. Do you know, do you remember what is? Yeah. 商店.
Store.
Store, yes. That is the small store. Little store. 小商店. Okay.
小,
and then. 小商店.
小商店.
Also here we have 小杯子.
Small cup.
Yes, small cup, 小杯子. So you can see that my cup is not small. Yeah, my cup is very, very huge, very big. So we'll use another word. Yeah, so this one is 大. So if like small cup is 小杯子, then how to say the big cup? Yeah, we can use the word 大杯子. Yes, 大杯子. 大杯子. Yes. Really, really big, really huge. Yeah. So if you like write this letter, you can see that the word 小, it looks like very small. It won't take many place. It will really like slim, short, small. But if you like the word, write the word 大, it's similar. But you can see that it has the, yeah, you can see that their drawing is like to the outside. But if you like what write the letter 小, the drawing is like in the inside, in the middle. All right. So this is we call 小, and this one is 大. Okay. So we have 大 and 小, big and small. Just now I've said that the primary school student we call 小学生. Then how to say university student?
大学生.
Very good. 大学生. Yes.
谢谢啊.
So that, yeah, that is what we say 大学生. That is the university student. Alright? Okay. And also, we have primary school student, we have university student, then how to say middle school student? So here, besides these two, 大 and 小, we also should have learned a word which indicates the middle, okay, the middle part. So this word we call 中. 中.
Zhong.
You see? 中. Yeah, 中. This is like when we talk about China. China is called 中国. It's the same word. Same word. 中国. So it's the same word. So 中国, the word 中, it means middle, middle size. All right? Middle size or middle. So if you want to say a high school student, sorry, a middle school student, we will say it's called what?
中学生.
Very good. 中学生. Yeah, this is middle school. Students. Okay. I've known that some of you are just like graduate from the middle school, and some of you are at the university age. So maybe some of you is 大学生 and some of you is 中学生. Okay. Yes. So here we learn these three different level of to talk about the size. 小中. All right, 小中大. And then also, when we talk about the word 小 here, I think we should know that in Chinese, in our culture, we like to use this word 小 to name people. Yeah, that is actually, it's not the real name, but sometimes we will use the word 小 to talk to name people. Yeah, to give them a nickname. Yeah, a nickname. For example, I've seen that one of our students is called Xiao Li, right?
So
they're just now. I think I've seen Xiao Li just now. Yeah, Xiao Li here. It is a very popular name in China. Xiao Li is very popular. Sometimes we will think that the word Xiao, sometimes we will plus a name, one of your name. One of your name. Yeah. For example, for me, you can see that my Chinese name is Yang Yun. So sometimes people will call me Xiao Yang. This is my family name. So you can put the word Xiao in front of your family name or your first name. It is very popular to use this saying. All right, it's very popular in China. So we seldom call people the full name. Yeah, we seldom call the full name. So sometimes when we will use the word we will use this word xiao to name people or to call people. Yeah, so they xiao yang or 小韵. This is my first name. Yun is my first name. All right. So if my friend, some of my friends, they will call me by my first name. Yeah, they will call me by my first name. So they will call, sometimes they will call me 小韵. Yeah. But some other people, if they are not familiar with me or if they are not quite close, they will call me 小杨. How about now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Oh, that's great. That's great. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry about the internet because it's quite complicated in China. We have to overrule the Chinese internet so that we can like we I have to like find a bridge to go over the Chinese internet and then so that I can like reach you. Yeah, so sometimes the bridge is not stable, so some it will have some problems. Yeah, I'm so sorry about that. All right, so let's come back here. Just now we talked about the small one, the small, right? And then the middle, and then also we have the big or the huge one. And then just now I've talked about the size. So I think this is like related to your major, right? This is related to your major. So when we talk about the size of the clothes, we have like different size. For example, we have the small size, and then the medium size, and then the large size, right? So we can also use this one to talk about the 大中小, okay? For the small size, we will call this is 小马. Yeah, 小马. The word 马 here means size. Yeah, medium size, 小马. And then how do you say medium size?
中文。
Yes, very good. We have 中马. Yeah, 中马. And then we also have 大马, right? The large size, the L size, we call 大马. Okay, so we have 小马, 中马, and 大马. This is like it is connected with your what you are learning. Okay, talking about the size of the clothes. Yeah, I think you can like remember this, and then next time maybe you can like talk with your clients or talk with your colleagues, your workmate. Yeah, we have 小马, medium size. Sorry, small size. 中马, medium size. This one, 中马. And then large size, 大马. This one. Okay, all right. Yeah. Okay, let's continue. Let's continue. And this one we 椅子, and then yes, 椅子, chair, 椅子. I think this we have learned this one, so no worry about this. And then also we have 下面, 下面. So this one also is the one we have learned before. 下面, that means the down, right? The under somewhere, okay? For example, we also have 椅子下面, that means under the chair. Right? 椅子下面. Shoe 下面, that is under the book. Okay? If you under something, you can say something 下面. Alright. Okay? And then we have like some more things, some more new words we should learn here. And then here, this one, 工作，
工作。
工作，工作 it means work. It can use to be a verb form or a noun for this phrase. All right. So when we talk about 工作, we can say 你的工作. Yeah, that means your job. Okay, 你的工作 or If I want to say my job, how to say?
我的工作。
Very good. 我的工作. So when I introduce to you, I will say 我的工作是老师. My job is teacher. Okay? 我的工作是老师. And then if you want to like some other people's job, you can say 李月的工作. That is the people. Yeah, her name is Li Yue. So we can also say Li Yue 的工作. Yeah, and then we can say Li Yue 的工作是老师. So this is when we talk about this 工作, this is all the noun form. Yes, this is the noun form. And also the word 工作 also can use as the verb. For example, like 不工作. Okay, 不工作. That means you don't work. Okay, you don't work means 不工作. You can say if people ask you, what's your job? 你的工作是什么? You can tell maybe you are not working. You can tell them that 我不工作. That means I don't work. Okay, all right, I don't work. And also when people ask, sometimes people will ask in this way, like, 你妈妈工作吗? It means like whether your mom worked or not, right? Your mom worked or not. 你妈妈工作吗? And then B will answer, 我妈妈不工作. Yeah, that means my mom, she doesn't work. Okay? 不工作. Also here we have another words we will say same as 工作, that is what we call 上班. Okay, student, you can read out for me. Yeah, 上班.
Shang Ban
Yes, this is similar to the word 工作, but it is the verb form. This one is the verb form. Alright? So when we say 我要上班, or 我想上班, that means I want to go to work. Okay, that is 上班. Similar phrase we have here. We also have 上班. Also, we also have 上学.
上学，
Yeah, 上学. 上学 means go to school, right? So 上班 means go to work. It means go to work. And then if you say 上学, that means go to school. Alright? Go to work, go to school. We have 上班 and 上学. Also, we have 上课.
上课，
上课 means have class. Yes, this means have class, or you go to have class. You go to the class. That means maybe you can say go to the class, right? Go to the class. We will say 上课. For example, like now, 我们在上课. We are having class now, right? And then also you can also say that when people ask you, oh, 你在CGTI做什么? What are you doing in CGTI? You can say, oh, 我在CGTI 上课. Okay, 我在CGTI 上课. That means I study or I go to class in CGTI. All right. Okay, so this one 上班 means you go to work. Then how to say you go off the work? Do you still remember how to say the opposite word of the word 上? The opposite.
Share
We'll call
by.
this one 下. Yes, very good. 下. So here we will say 下班. 下班.
Share by.
So we have, yeah, 上班, that means you go to work. And then if you like get off work, we will say 下班. Yes, this one is 下班. So shang and xia is opposite. They are the opposite. Okay, all right. So we have shang ban, we also have xia ban. And also here, if you like go to school, we have shang xue, but we won't have xia xue, we will have fang xue. Different. Fang xue. All right, fang xue. But for the class, we have shang ke and then also we have xia ke. It's the same. Xia ke. Okay, so for example, when we say just now for our class, right? Our class begins at 4:30 in Cambodia, right? So for every Thursday, we will have class on 4:30. So we can say 我们, you can talk in this way, 我们, when
我们,
to have class.
我们,
4点半上课. Yes, very good. 我们4点半上课, that means we will have class at 4:30. Then when is the class is over?
我们6点上下课.
Yes, very good. 我们6点下课. Very good. Okay. 我们6点下课. 我们4点半上课. And then 我们6点下课. All right. So if I want you to talk about when you go to work, so when you go to work, when?
我上班.
When? What is the time?
我8点上班.
Okay, very good. 我8点上班. Yes, and then when you get off the work?
我6点下班.
Very good. 6点下班. Okay. Yes. So here, when you talk them together, you can omit the subject 我. So you can say in the whole sentence like 我8点上班. 6点下班. All right. Yeah. So this is how you can use this to describe your daily routine, right? Your daily routine. So you can tell me when you go to work and when you get off the work. 我8点上班，6点下班. Okay. And then for our class, 我们4点半下上课. 我们6点半下课. All right. And then I'll try to write the Chinese in this way. 我们4点半上课. I know that some of you want to learn the Chinese writing. So I will like write the Chinese character here. 我们6点下课. All right. 6点下课. And then also here, 我8点上班，6点下班. Yeah. So you can learn. If you want to learn how to write a Chinese character, you can like copy this one. Try to write this one. Yeah. When we write the Chinese character, sometimes we like write from the left top to the right top, from left to right, from top to bottom. So we have this sequence, left to right, bottom, top to bottom. Okay, so you can like try to write the Chinese character. All right? Very good. Are you okay here? Yeah, maybe can take a snapshot. Okay. Send it in the group so you can do some review after that. All right. So let's continue here. This one we have also this one we call 医院. Yeah, 医院.
医院.
Like the letter E. Same pronunciation. 医院.
医院.
Yes, very good. 医院. Okay, 医院 means hospital. Yeah, 医院 means hospital. For example, like if you are ill, you need to go to the hospital, right? 去医院.
去医院.
去医院. And also here, in 医院, we have 医生, right? 医生.
医生.
医生. 医生 means the doctor. Okay, all right? 医生. For example, like, do you have some relative? He or she is the doctor?
他是医生.
他是医生. Yes, you can say 他是医生. Or maybe you can like for introduction, like if your father is the doctor, you can say 我爸爸是医生. All right, 我爸爸是医生. 我爸爸是医生. Or maybe you can say, 我哥哥是医生, my brother, my elder brother is the doctor. You can like try to stay in this way. All right? Very good. Okay, yes. Let's continue. So here, after we learn the new words, here we need to talk about the language point. So for this unit, for this lesson, we are going to learn a verb or a verb called 在.
在.
Yeah, 在, the word 在. The word 在 here, sometimes it is a verb. When it is used in different sentences, you have different meaning. But here, sometimes if you use it as the verb form, when you talk about the word 在, it means stay. All right, stay. Stay, 在. For example, like you guys, where are you? If I ask, where are you? How would you answer me?
我在家.
Very good. 我在家, that means I'm at home. Okay, yeah, you can say 我在家. So the word 在, you can put the location. Yeah, if you like want to talk about it, you can like put the location next to it. You can say 我在家 or 我在学校. 我在学校. Or for example, like me, I would say 我在中国, I'm in China. Then if I ask you, if I say 我在中国, 你们在哪里? How would you answer me?
我在柬埔寨.
Very good. 我在柬埔寨. That's very good. So that means we can you can understand me. You can understand my question. All right. And then for now, I'm in the school. 我在学校. 我在学校. 你们在哪里? I say I'm at the school. 我在学校, 你们在哪里?
我们在家，是吗，老师？
Yes, very good. 我们在家, yes, yes. That's good, that's good. Yeah, so I say 我在学校, and then you can tell me, 我们在家. At home. Very good. 我们在家. Yeah. So sometimes, like when we making the phone call, if you like, you met your friends, you ask your friend out, you can say, ah, 我在商店了. I'm in the shop. 我在商店了.你在哪里? And your friend said, ah, 我在家. I'm still at home. And then you will be very angry. Why are you still at home? Right? Okay, so this is the word 在. This is the first meaning of the word 在. Same words, it has different meaning. So let's see here. Here, the word 在, it is also, if the word 在 puts a verb, you put a verb behind the word 在, it indicates that the action is on. Sometimes it just like the present tense, the present perfect tense of English, in English. Yeah, it is kind of like a tense. So, for example, like we can say that, for example, like we are now having the class, right? We are now having the class. So we will say, 我们在 上课，我们在上课。Yeah，我们在上课. That means we are having the class now. Right? We are having the class. 我们在上课. We are having the class. Okay. So this is the second meaning, another meaning of the word 在. So it depends. It depends on the sentence, the situation, or depends on the sentence. If I just say that the word 在, it puts the location, all right? So it put in front of the location, it means stay. So if the word 在 puts in front of a verb, for example, like 上课 or 上班, that means it is used as a present perfect tense, all right? So, for example, like 我在上课, or 我在上学, or 我在上班, right? Or you can say 我在看电影, I'm watching a movie, right? That it means you are doing that kind of things, right? Very good. And then number three. The third meaning of the word 在, same. This is the same word, but another meaning, different meaning. We will call 在, it is a preposition. Yes, it's a preposition. So, for example, like if I say 我在朋友家喝茶, this word 在, then it doesn't mean stay. It is just a preposition like in my friend's home. All right. So this is like you can wait after me. 我在朋友家喝茶.
我在朋友家喝茶.
Yes, 我在朋友家喝茶. That means I am drinking tea. I drink teas in my friend's home. All right. Okay. Let's see. Sentence number two. I'll read the Chinese and then you can try to figure out the meaning. 他们在学校上课. What does it mean? 他们.
We study at school.
Yes, this means they are.
They.
在学校上课.
They.
What does it mean by the word 上课?
上课,
have
oh.
class.
上课 means,
class.
Yeah, have class. Very good, have class. So when we say they are having class, okay, 在学校,
at school.
Yeah, at school, very good. Right. It's different. So I've noted that the order of the word is different between Chinese and the English. So in English, we'll put the preposition of the place at the end of the sentence. Yeah, at the end of the sentence. So we can see here. This is the preposition place at school. And then, but in Chinese, we would like put it in the middle part. All right. And then for the verb here, 上课, having class, we'll put it at the end. So the order of the sentence is different. Okay. When we talk about the English, we would like put the verb form in the middle. But in Chinese, we will put the verb form at the last part. Right? So we will tell people that first of all, where are we? And then we will talk about what we do in the place. Okay? So we will say 他们在学校上课. All right?
他们在学校上课。
Very good. 他们在学校上课. Okay, and then in the next sentence, in the last sentence, we'll say, 我儿子在医院工作.
My son works at the hospital.
Yeah, very good. My son is working at the hospital, or my son works in the hospital. 我儿子在医院工作, or you can say 我儿子在医院上班, yeah. So also, for example, like you guys, how would you say, 我们在 CGTI, so you are working in CGTI or learning in CGTI?
CSE.
学习, okay. So how to say? So for the whole sentence, if you want to talk, say I study in CGTI. How to say? 我们
CSE
CSE
汉语在。
我们在 CGTI 学习。
Yes, very good. 我们在CGTI. We put the place in the front, right? 我们在CGTI 学习汉语. Yes. 我们在CGTI 学习汉语. Okay, and then put what you do at last. 学习汉语. Or 学习中文. Yes, we will stay in this way. 我们在CGTI 学习, yeah, 学习汉语. Okay, yeah. For me, I will say in this way. So I will say I teach. Or I work in GDPT. How to say? Maybe you can like make a sentence in this way. Miss Yang. So for me, you can call Yang Lao Shi, right? So Yang Lao Shi works in GDPT. How to say?
Yang Lao Shi zai CTDI.
Yeah, 老师, yes, I. No, no, I'm not working in CGTI. I work in GDPT, yeah, Guangdong Polytechnic. Yeah, 杨老师在 GDPT work? Yeah, 工作, very good. Yeah, 工作, yeah. So that is how we introduce, how we talk about our jobs. Tell people where are you working or what are you doing, right? So you can say 杨老师, yes, 在 GDPT 工作, what? 杨老师在 GDPD 工作。You should like try to make the sentence. For now, you cannot only learn the word only because the vocabulary is not enough. And then now you have to like learn more about how to make a whole sentence. Okay? How to make a whole sentence. So for our speaking test in the future, so you're going maybe at the end of this learning, we're going to have a test. So at the test, maybe you need to like tell me something about yourself. So you can use in this way, like 我们在 CGTI 学习汉语，or 我们在 CGTI 学习，we are learning in CGTI. 好，Yes. So I will. I'll make a screenshot for you. Let's continue. Let's continue. Also here, we have another words. This is the interrogative pronoun. That is how we call 哪儿。哪儿? Yeah, 哪儿? 哪儿? Yeah, 哪儿? 哪儿 means where. Yeah, where. So, for in English, we put the word where in the front of the question, like where are you going? Yeah, where are you going? We write in this way. Where are you going? But in Chinese, we would like make in this different way. Then we will use it like you are going where? In Chinese. So when translated in Chinese, we have first of all we have the subject. Yeah, the subject 你. And then the word form. And then you put the word where, nas. Na. Okay, this is the structure. This is the substructure of the sentence, right? For example, if I ask, where are you going? How would you translate in Chinese?
你在哪儿？
你 go go，
你
你去
去
哪儿
在，你去。
？Yes，你去哪？This one, this sentence. Yes, sentence number three. This one, 你去哪？Where are you going? Yeah, if I ask like where are you, you can say 你在哪？你 where are you? Yeah, when you are like making the appointment with your friends, you hang out with your friends and you go to the meeting point, but you can't see your friend. You make a phone call, say, 你在哪儿? Yeah, that means where are you? 你在哪儿? 你在哪儿? And also we would like try to use this one to ask the question about something. We try to ask the questions about something, in this way. For example, we have learned this the locality of something, right? Just now, and then for the last week, we have like talk about where is the little dog, right? Where is something? So we will like in this way, 小黄鸭在哪儿? Yeah, the object. Where is the object? So we can put the word object here. 在哪儿? All right. 在哪儿? Yes. So I'll ask like 你在哪儿? Where are you? All right. And also here, besides 哪儿, we also have another interrogative practical. This word we call ne.
Ne.
Ne, yes. The word ne, sometimes we like use it as the subject. You just like, if you want to like ask something, where is something or how about something, you can just put the word something and then put the word ne. That is okay. For example, if you would like want to ask, oh, where is my little cat? You can say, 我的小猫在哪? And then also you can say, 我的小猫呢? Yeah, 我的小猫呢? Yeah, it can also use to indicate or say, where is my cat? This word 呢 is very useful. Yeah, it's very useful in our saying. Yeah, when we like to talk about something, where is something? Or what about something? We can say 呢. Like we have an example. For example, if I say 我喝茶, I drink tea, 我喝茶. And then I will say 你呢? That means, what about you? Alright, 我喝茶,你呢? What about you? Okay, 我喝茶,你呢? Then you can answer me, oh, 我喝咖啡. Right, I like coffee. Alright? Yes. Okay, let's continue. So after we have learned all this language point here, and then we have some other, we have some tests, some tests we should learn about it. So first one, test number one is at home. So at home, A asks, 小猫在哪? So you can see from the picture, 小猫在哪?
小猫在桌子上面。
Yes, very good. 小猫在桌子上面。 And then, 小狗在哪?
小狗在桌子下面。
Yes, 小狗在桌子下面。 Okay, so when you want to ask about something, you can say, oh, something在哪? Where is something? Okay, 小猫在哪? 小狗在哪? And then also you can say, 手机在哪? Where is your phone? 手机在哪?
手机在我的手。
在我的手上, it's very good. 手机在我的手上。 And you can also say, 手机在桌子上面, right? You can also say, yeah, 手机在桌子上面。 Okay, very good. Okay, let's see, number two. Let's see number two. Let's see the picture here. 哥哥在哪?
哥哥在外面打游戏。打游戏。
Yes, 哥哥在外面打游戏. Yeah, 外面 means outside. Right, outside. Normally, when we talk about 外面, that means outside the room. Sometimes we will say 客厅, all right? 在客厅, that means the living room. Okay? Yeah. 外面 means outside. Outside, sometimes it is like used to refer to living room. Okay? So we'll say 客厅.
客厅,
right? 客厅, yeah, 客厅. Okay, 哥哥在外面打游戏. Do you still remember 打游戏?
Play game.
Yeah, play game. Still the word 打. We have talked about this one. 打 means you hit. You use your hand to do something. Yeah, you use your hand to hit it. That means 打. Okay? 哥哥在外面打游戏, play games. So, if I ask you in this way, so look at the picture here. 哥哥在做什么？哥哥在做什么？做什么 means what is he doing? So what is he doing? 哥哥在做什么？He is
打游戏。
打游戏。Yes, very good. So you can answer me. 哥哥在打游戏。Yeah, that means he is like playing them. All right. 哥哥在打游戏。Okay. So if I ask 哥哥在哪 means I want to know where is he. Okay. So you can say 哥哥在外面打游戏。If I ask 哥哥在干什么？哥哥在做什么？That means I'm asking what is the 哥哥 doing? Okay, so you can say 哥哥在打游戏。Yeah, very good. Okay, let's see. Another question is like this one. 弟弟在哪？弟弟在哪？
弟弟在里面睡觉。
Very good. 弟弟在里面睡觉。睡觉 means like sleeping. Yeah, sleeping. 弟弟在里面睡觉。So here we have another word, 里面。Just now we
Inside.
have 外面。Yeah, we have 外面。That means outside. And then here we have 里面。It means inside. Very good. Inside. So sometimes inside it refers to the bedroom. Yeah, bedroom. We call 房间。
房间。
Yeah, 房间。So you can also say 弟弟在房间睡觉。房间。Yeah, you can say 弟弟在里面睡觉，or you can say 弟弟在房间睡觉。All right, 哥哥在客厅打游戏。弟弟在房间睡觉。Alright. So also here, sometimes we have 哥哥 and 弟弟。And so can you guess 妈妈在哪里？Can you make a guess? 妈妈在哪里？Can you make a guess? 妈妈在哪里？So, according to your situation, where is your mom? 妈妈在哪里？
Kitchen 在你说什么的事？
妈妈在哪里？哪儿？妈妈在哪儿？So, normally, where's your mom?
我妈妈在厨房。
Yeah, 妈妈在厨房。Very good, very good. You can answer me in this way. So normally, 妈妈，yeah, she in the kitchen, right? 妈妈在厨房。So 厨房，what is she doing? Cooking. We say 做饭。
做饭。
Yes，做饭。妈妈在。厨房做饭，做饭。Yeah, making cooking. Alright, 妈妈在厨房做饭。Alright, so if we want to like make more about it, we can say 啊，哥哥在外面打游戏，弟弟在里面睡觉。And then 妈妈在哪儿？妈妈在厨房做饭。妈妈在厨房做饭。Then, how about 爸爸？So can you guess where's 爸爸？爸爸在哪？So can you make me sentence？爸爸在哪？Normally, where's your father？Where is your father? working? Is it working? Or maybe he's like watching TV? Yeah, watching TV?
Or
So,
Baba.
Baba Zai. Maybe we can say Baba is working. Baba Zai.
工作.
Yes, very good. We can say Baba Zai Gong Si Shang Ban. Yeah, Gong Si means company. Yeah. Yeah, company. Baba Zai Gong Si company Shang Ban. Okay, working in a company. All right, so we can say in this way, yeah, Baba Zai Gong Si. Okay, company Shang Ban, working. Yeah. And then your mom, Mama Zai Chu Fang, Zuo Fan. Yeah, Zai Chu Fang, Zuo Fan. Yeah, that is how we usually do the way. All right, so guys, you can like read after me for the whole sentence, like here. 哥哥在外面打游戏。Yes. 弟弟在里面睡觉。Yeah, very good. 妈妈在厨房做饭。Yes. 爸爸在公司上班。
爸爸在公司上班。
Yes, very good. So this is how what is the key grammar and then key sentence we should learn for this lesson. Okay, so when you are talking about what are people doing in some place, so we'll use the word in this way. Somebody inside the place and then do something. All right. Yes, very good. So here, let me do it in this way. So you can like have a review after that. Yes. Okay. Sorry.